Hello, I'm Marc Desgrosseillers from Technical Support here at Pix4D, and today I'll be talking to you about the Capture app and basic troubleshooting related to the app. I want to make a few general comments to start this video. Few things to check. So you want to make sure that you have the latest firmware for your drone and the latest version of the app, whether you're using Android or iOS. Also, in the settings of the app, it's possible to choose which drone you're flying, so you really want to make sure that you've selected the appropriate drone. One more thing, when you're using Capture, the manufacturer's app should not be running in the background, so you want to make sure that you kill that process. However, one thing to check before this is to make sure that when you try to fly your drone with the manufacturer's app, that this is working. Because if the drone cannot fly with the manufacturer's app, then it's very likely that it will not be able to fly with Capture as well. Now, what I want to do is I want to go over a few common situations and explain how to solve these issues. So the first one is that there's a red cross on the takeoff checklist. Now, this takeoff checklist is some kind of automated troubleshooting, so it will tell you which item you should investigate. And we also have an in-depth article on our support website that will tell you for each item how to turn it from a red cross to a green checkmark. Once everything is green, you can start the mission. What might happen is that the drone takes off, is in the air, but will not start the mission. Now, what you can do is you can abort the mission and take back manual control of the drone, and then you can either land your drone or you could even start the new mission while the drone is in the air. So you just press start mission again. One thing to investigate if this keeps happening is to check the settings in the manufacturer's app. Let me give you an example. It could be that in the manufacturer's app there's a height maximum, so the drone will not be able to fly above this height. But in Pix4Dcapture, you ask the mission to be flown higher than this limit. So then the drone will go up to the flight height, to the maximum, but will not be able to get to the correct altitude to start the mission, and that's why it will get stuck. So that's why we recommend checking the manufacturer's in the manufacturer's app to check the settings to make sure that they don't conflict. Now, one thing that could happen also is that your tiles in the background map, they could be missing or outdated. In the Android version, there's something you can do about this. So first thing is you can change to roadmap view, because sometimes that's more updated. It's also possible to change the base map provider in the settings, or if you have your own background map as a KML or KMZ file, you can load it yourself, and this you can do in the project view in the Android version. One issue that you can have with the iOS version is how to fly large areas. Because indeed, there's no project view in the iOS version. This is something that we're working on at the moment, but at the time of this video, it's only available on Android. So how can you fly large areas with the iOS version? Well, what we recommend is to make several grid missions. And what you can do is you can use a reference point in the background map to align the different missions. And then you take the images from all these small missions and you put them in the same Pix4D project and you process them all together. Last issue I want to talk about is a synchronization failure. It could be that the drone records all the images on its SD card or its internal memory, but that these images, they don't quite make it to your mobile device. So they still exist, they're still on the drone's memory or the drone's SD card, but they're just not on your mobile device, so you cannot, for example, upload to the cloud directly. No worries, what you can do is you can just take your images from the drone, download them to your computer, and then you can start a new project with these images and you can do the processing either on the desktop or on the cloud. One thing to mention is that these images, they will in all likelihood, they will still be geolocated because the geolocation information is written directly in the images by the drone. So you're not losing out information here. Your project will still be geolocated. Great. So that's all I wanted to say about basic troubleshooting with Pix4Dcapture. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.